right, and so then in like the second half of this, we have to propel the vehicle, the frequency propelled. So now I'm like, well, I gave you the trajectory. You're at planet 80, and you're going to planet 90. All right. So, and then you have this little space shuttle deal in the middle. Now, and going at the frequency decrease to the frequency increase boost to go and be that big footstep on the next planet. Okay, so now the drama is okay, so there's this free floating ship, and how is the ship itself going to not veer off? Okay, because you can already have your directionals, you already know, you can see camera sight action, that's the planet. Okay, so your camera is already there. Okay, so you can have that hooked up. However, that's not a guidance system. It's not the guidance system, it's just to see it with a camera. You know, you can try light guidance, you know. Anything that looks like that, follow. You can try that. You know, train the following. You know, that's the walk after. That's the go toward only. You can do that with computer. But I wasn't actually going at that route. That could be a subsequent second. I was actually going at the ship itself, now involving the freqs, the frequencies on either side. So you have the ship, let's have this ship is not all 110 frequency. You have the back of the ship being pushed at 110, and the front would be a light nose of maybe the 80 or maybe the 90. And so you have this 110 push, and then the sides of the ship. So you're not moving right or left. So yeah, I'm trying to find a new guidance system out of frequencies here. Okay, so they have, maybe not new at all. It could be ancient old, but yeah. So you have the sides as lesseners also. So let's say you have 108 on the right and left side. Okay, so you'll always be falling forward. In this, so you could be a round ship, you could be round, you could be an absolutely round spaceship and have total control, as long as only one point, the nose of that ship, has the lighter frequency. So you have the heavy push at the back of the ship, so you don't have to be even a square capsule or a rectangle. So, and then you'd have like the 108s on either side. So you'll have less chance of veering right or left, going off of your guidance. So you have that same directional. You know what I'm saying? And so there it is. Then so you just it's just like, you know, when somebody talks to you loudly, you're like, oh, your reaction is to move. It's the same reaction. So you're moving. Because you're the light, remember, you're the light, you're the one who's not talking loudly. You know, you're just making that reaction. So the back is the push of the heavy freq and the light freq in the front. So yeah, I guess so. So that gets the ship there. But yeah, there's that also. There is the guidance system of okay, that's the direction, because I'm seeing that. It has to match at this particular coordinate. It has to look like this. So yeah, as a, I imagine there'll be camera runs. They'll have camera a camera travel, direct travel, A to B, and that would be. So you know at this particular coordinate, the planet that you're headed towards should look exactly like this. It'll be this size, it'll be this shape, it'll be this even light. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, so you'll have that matching system. And so that'll be your correct, that's not correct. But then also you can go back to that, like I was saying, you could run with the frequency leverages of right and left, and your propeller, your propellant. So it does sound like a loud ship. It doesn't have to be, though, because, I mean, when we go into vibration, it does not have to be. It doesn't have to actually be a loud sound. Yeah. So yeah, that's the second half of that, so you're not just floating out there in space, you've got to get there. You're midway through and you have to get to planet 90. All right, so yeah, we got to get there. Now, all of this without gasoline or rocket-generated fuel propellants of our hideous day and age. Yeah, try something new.